But we collect requirements all the time, right? Every time we build a software system. So how do people cope with these difficulties? What are the best practices? In practice, developers or analysts usually identify a whole bunch of requirements, sometimes the easiest and most obvious ones. They bring those to the stakeholders, and the stakeholders have to read the requirements, understand them, and if they agree, sign off on them. And the problem is that in general, these requirements documents are difficult to read. They are long, they're often unstructured, they typically contain a lot of information, and in general, they're not exactly a pleasant read. So what happens is that often the stakeholders are short on time, overwhelmed by the amount of information they're given, and so they give in to the pressure and sign. And this is a bit of a dramatization, clearly, but it's clear that what we are looking at is not an ideal scenario. Clearly, this is not the way to identify the real purpose of a software system, to collect good requirements. And since one of the major causes for project failure is the inadequacy of requirements, we should really avoid this kind of scenario. We should follow a rigorous and effective requirements engineering process instead.